War also means destruction of the environment. According to the US military's climate change plan, the force intends to reduce CO2 emissions by 50% over the next 10 years, by converting military vehicle systems. Initially, the US military intended to switch to electric vehicles for all non-tactical operations. However, great advances in electric propulsion mean that even military vehicles can be converted to electricity, even if only partially. In addition to environmental problems, technology also offers military advantages. General Dynamics introduced a new version of the iconic M1 Abrams main battle tank during the Association of the United States Army annual meeting and exposition. The new version is called the Abrams-X, advertised as a state-of-the-art combat vehicle for the US Army. The Abrams-X technology demonstrator features reduced weight for improved mobility and transportability, delivering the same tactical range as the M1A2 Abrams with 50% less fuel consumption. Abrams-X will be equipped with a hybrid diesel-electric system that cuts fuel consumption in half, which is great for both emissions and for fighting. It also allows the tanks to sit silently but still be ready for action. General Dynamics also says that the tank will have limited silent mobility, meaning that it can run for short distances with the combustion engine off. This will make the tanks a lot more sneaky. Details about this new version's capabilities are very limited at present, but there are clear indications that it will feature a slate of improved weapons, sensors, and other equipment over existing M1 tanks, in addition to the ability to operate stealthily thanks to its hybrid propulsion system. From what we can see in these various promotional materials, the next generation Abrams has at least some changes to the general outward shape of the hull and turret. It's not clear whether this might reflect and changes to the crew composition in this version. All existing Abrams variants have four-person crews, with the driver in the hull and the commander, gunner, and loader in the turret. Regarding armament, the next generation Abrams tank looks to have a Kongsberg Protector RS-6 remote weapon station, armed with a variant of the 30mm M230 automatic cannon, mounted on top of the turret. Adding a remote weapon station with this gun to the Abrams would give the tank significant additional firepower, for use against lower-end aerial threats and various ground targets, which the vehicle's crew could operate without having to expose themselves to enemy fire. The next generation Abrams will likely be armed with a version of the XM360 main gun, an advanced 120mm type originally developed as part of the US Army's abortive Future Combat Systems program, based on the design of the muzzle brake seen in the renderings. A larger 140mm caliber gun is also being considered. Abrams-X will also inherit the combat system of its predecessor. It will also include the Trophy Active Protection System, already installed on some of the US Army's existing Abrams tanks. The renders shared by the company show a series of cameras installed around the hull, to give observers a 360-degree view of the outside situation.